new foods. So back to this discussion of opera, which is really odd because, you know, I've never really, you know, been, you know, opera specific. I've been in operas, I've danced in operas, I've sung in operas, but I've never really been hired as opera before specifically. It's always been ballet with the opera on the side, you know, like a dish. But so now it's just like really odd when I think about it, because I've been in the what do you call it, the Madame Butterfly. That was a great opera to be in. What's another one? Gosh dang it. Oh yeah, this other one, Macbeth. Now that one was a hysterical one, actually, because I was a witch in it. Yeah, so I was one of the three witches in Macbeth. Well, that was an interesting opera. It's another one. This was in Germany, all of these. What's the deal? There was another one that was kind of... Oh yeah, Jesus Christ Superstar. Now that one, whoa. Now, it's when you talk about an opera with a little bit of like 60s added to it. It was fun as all heck. Fun as all heck for everybody. Hosanna, Hezana, Sanazana, Ho, the whole bit. It was excellent. It was excellent fun. And the audience adored it. They went crazy for it. I think they even put on extra shows in bookings that they hadn't planned on before. So that one was a huge hit. Jesus Christ Superstar, yeah, they loved it. I think I was in the Bartered Bride once here, actually, in Oakland. I don't know why, I don't even remember it. I just remember the title, and that's about all. But then, yeah, that was a long time ago. But yeah, so I haven't really been in that many, like, operas, and Capriccio. Oh yeah, no, I was in Capriccio, that little one. I was the little dancer in it. With Gabrielle, Hubner, very, very beautiful singer, Gabrielle Hubner. So yeah, it was in that one. I got to dance for her, be her little happy dancer, her dream dancer. It was fun, a fun skit zone. I didn't like the costume though, it was terrible and it ruined the opera. I think the costume ruined the opera. It was the wrong color, it was the wrong tone, it was too flash. And it's something that they tend to do now, and I'm kind of bummed out over the removal of classicism in traditionalism in opera. It's just so like, hey, get everybody out here so they look like they just, you know, got out of their job at 7-Eleven and they ran on stage and sing, you know, in their sweatpants. You know, and I get a little bummed out about it. I just don't like that look. I prefer all of the circumstance and the pomp, everything, you know, full out. None of this cheap remakes of 1990 or 2000 or 2010, you know, none of that. I just don't like it. Anyway, other opera. Let me think of another opera. Oh, there's some other ones, but those are the ones that are really sticking out in my mind. And that one scene in Madame Butterfly, where we're helping her, we're her three little dancers, and you know, it's always when the diva's there, she's singing her aria, and then the little dancers come out and they do something, or yeah, that one there was three of us, and. Gosh, she was great. That was a phenomenal singer. I can't remember her name though, and so go ahead, shoot me. But yeah, she was excellent. She sang her butterfly story. She was on the ground, you know, singing. You know, that he's not there. He's just not there. He's gone away. He's not coming back, you know, anytime soon, but he's supposed to. And where is he, and all of these dramas, and you know, she's so confused, and yet she, and, oh, it's what a story, what a tremendous story, actually, you know, that she has this kid, and then I don't know, does she kill it, or what happens to it, she doesn't want it anymore, she gives it away, I don't know, there's all kinds of versions, But yeah, as soon as the guy comes back, he didn't want the kid. He didn't want the kid, so I think she throws like a one of those harikaris on it and gets rid of it. I don't know. It's kind of one of those types of, you know, it starts out so sweet. The butterfly sweet, you know. And then, wow, I guess things don't go well for her. She doesn't kill the kid, actually. I take it back. She ends up, oh, that's what happens. She kills herself. She kills herself. She gives the kid away to the maid. That's what happens. Yeah, the maid. Yeah, that song before Un bel di vedremo. That little song with Tachi is so good. That little song right there. It's quite exciting. Yeah, I like that part. I think Tachi was the maid, but yeah. Oh my gosh. So back to singing. What I was wanting to talk about was, aside from, I get built up really quickly in regular normal life. People really aggravate me quickly, and I drama out. So I don't know what to do about it because I can't really smoke marijuana. I'm not really that type. Maybe I'll drink it in a tea or something, but I'm afraid it's going to affect my brain because I don't really have, you know, like smart learning here going on at my age in life. And I'm like, well, okay, come on, feed all these words into my head, you know, feed them in there. And how am I going to get them in there to stick, you know? And I'm like, well, okay, so I'm taking sugar out, really, really trying to take sugar out of my life. And then I'm looking at other things, like taking caffeine out completely. Now, this is something on the last, I don't know, last month, I've taken caffeine out of my life. It's gone. So I'm really on just teas after tea after tea, and it's kind of interesting because I put myself on a learning binge with the words, removed caffeine from my life, and now I'm like, whoa, I know songs now. They're stuck in my head. Sometimes a few of those sentences run away, but a lot of them are stuck in my head. So this is great. I have songs there. Arias. And so then I'm like, okay, now this is it. I'm gonna look up diet. You know, what diet do these singers go on? You know, is there what's the diet? Because I'm stuck right now on pianissimo because I talked too loud yesterday, very much so. So I'm like, well, what is the diet? Well, we have tomatoes are apparently ousted. I was going to do one of those shows that, you know, you put up the tomato and do the big cross out with the X because everybody needs everything so visual, but I decided not to. I'll just go with the talking. But yeah, tomatoes are a no. And I'm like, how come tomatoes are a no when all of these beautiful singers come from bel canto? I don't get that. So I'm a little bit confused. And but then I go back to we can go back to Enrico Caruso, and he had like a real problem there in Italy, and he ate pasta one night. He ate some spaghetti pasta one night, and I think he got in all kinds of trouble with gosh, I don't even know. He may have even died that night. I don't know. He either died in San Francisco or he died there, but it was the day after he ate spaghetti dinner. So maybe spaghetti is out, and I find that very strange because if you're not allowed to eat the sauce, it just doesn't go with all this abrakame and everything. It just doesn't seem to fit. Yeah, but then we can look at callas, you know, and obviously we can all just eat dolmas until we're blue in the face. But I don't think that's the way only is to just eat dolmas. So, and like this afternoon, I'm like, well, crud, I put potatoes. I say I never eat potatoes, ever. It's just like one of my taboos. My mother always said, don't eat potatoes, they're the nightshade. Ooh, and you can't have nightshade. But there's so many potatoes in the kitchen, they're growing eyeballs. And so I cut up the, I made a potato leek soup. And then I sang this afternoon, and my voice is just gone, just gone. It didn't like potatoes. It didn't like me being over dramatic yesterday with regular human discussion. It didn't like that. So it doesn't like potatoes, and it does not like regular human discussion. Next thing I did also that I can blame. I'm in the blame game at food, okay? I can blame it's a mango tango, some kind of a drink called a mango tango. It's very delicious and rich tasting and yummy, and it makes a wonderful salad dressing if you mix it in with the salad of the oils. What's my hair doing? If you mix it in with the oils, and a yogurt, it's a very good dressing. But anyway, so the mango tango, but not before singing. So the whole thing about having a cold, something cold also is bad for the voice. You're not supposed to have a cold drink ever. Okay, so no cold drink. All right. And then, wait a minute, no dairy. Yeah, no dairy, none. No cheese, no dairy, no milk, none of that. So we have flax milks, we have soy milks. And then they say women aren't supposed to have soy milk so much, so we have the flax milk. Okay, so yeah, so that's where we're at milk-wise. It's not really. I guess there's almond milk. So what do we have? What can we eat? We start to look at, if I can't have the cheese, I can't really have the tomato, I can't really have anything cold, drink-wise. Yeah. Whoa, it starts to, and then you can't have caffeine in anything, you know, and you can't have sugars, and then they go right away and point that Geiger counter at chocolate. And so I'm like, well, oh my God, I can't even have chocolate now. So there's no chocolate because of the caffeine in it, even if you're having chocolate that is no sugar. So, okay, so now this is no fun. This is no fun, because certain things, you know, I don't know, just starts to become really, really, if you want to start really singing professionally, you have to cut back on all of these little gadgets that you're used to, you know what I mean? And those little gadgets are these food extras, you know, because if the chocolate is a disturber in the brain because of the caffeine, and you can't learn the words, then it's a no. You can't have chocolate. You can't have any coffee. You can't have any, even decaffeinated coffee has caffeine. You can't have any of those things. And you can't have black teas. So it's just setting me straight priority-wise, because I'm really thrilled. I'm really thrilled that I have learned these songs. When I'm looking at, I don't know, I'm up to 20, about 20... maybe 25 now, you know, really getting those words. And I don't need my books. I have all these books, so I don't need them any longer, you know. This is my singing books. So when I have all of these word for word, I don't even have to look at them anymore. It's kind of exhilarating. So, but I'm going to only say that's because I'm not using those disturbers in my brain. Those disturbers, and if I, like, if I make some brownies and I'll eat some of those, and I eat a brownie and I'll go start learning words, forget it. And I'm like, well, is it the placebo now? I've been taught that, and so I'm not going to learn? I don't know. So now I'm kind of stuck for sure that I cannot go with the chocolates. Can't go with the chocolates, and I can't go with the caffeines. So, anyhoot. But it doesn't mean I know all of them. My gosh, there's so many here. And some of them I'm really, they may be like very fun to sing, very great and wonderful, like Mille et Lys. But, oh my gosh, that one is, my brain just does not want to start learning it. It's a German one from Tannhauser. So, yeah. Oh, that was the other opera. I was in that one. Duh. I was in Tannhauser. In Stuttgart. And now that opera, oh my God. That one went on and on and on and on and on and on and on forever. And it was lovely and wonderful to take part of it. And it was almost like a journey with a whole bunch of people, even the audience. When you go on a trip with everybody, that's the kind of opera it is. It is so compelling and so time-fulfilling that you're in there for the long haul. You go to this Tannhauser, you're in there for the long haul. And yeah, oh yeah, it's very biblical and blah, blah, blah. But oh my gosh, talk about a journey with the thespians, the dancers, the singers, the audience, just a tremendous opera, yeah. So yeah, that was a good one. Yauba. See, anyway, so yeah, so I'm just talking about foodstuffs. Whoa, it's tripping me out because I can't have very much. I'm getting limited. Oh, no salsas. No salsas, no hot peppers, none of that. And also no balsamics. Nothing too vinegary that will strip the throat. So then salads become a little more difficult and more like, well, you know, yeah, and you can take it easy on that lemon also, and take it easy on orange juices and citruses. So all of these have a tendency to overstrip the throat. Yow. Okay.